The Minnesota Rocker dropped their last three matches, all ending with a disappointing Game 5 performance. Their schedule for the CDL Major 2 qualifiers has been a real grind, facing off against the Major 1 champ, Toronto Ultra, then taking on Optic Texas and Boston Breach. And now they've got Atlanta FaZe, the LA Thieves, and the Miami Heretics left to tackle. Going up against the current top three teams out of six total matches, that's just plain brutal. If I had to bet, I'd say they'll take down the Thieves and the Heretics, but that FaZe matchup, it's a toss-up. If they can snag just those two wins, they'll most likely be starting on the loser's bracket side at the Miami Heretics Major 2, which kicks off on March 21st. Now let's dive deep into Minnesota's MVP, and if you're a fan, you already know who I'm talking about. It's none other than the rookie sensation, Thomas Linz Gregorio. This kid has been tearing it up at just 19 years old. He's making plays that scream veteran in every single series. Seriously, he's been dropping jaws left and right with his insane IQ plays. But despite his stellar performance, the Roker are sitting at a tough 0-3 record during Major 2. Crazy, right? I mean, the guy's been carrying the team on his back. But hey, even the best need a solid squad behind them. So let's kick things off by breaking down some of his sickest plays from Minnesota's first showdown against Toronto. Starting with Game 1 Hardpoint, it was a roller coaster ride that ended in disaster for Minnesota during the second set of rotations. Toronto Ultra dominated P1 of the second set, securing a full 60. Moving on to the supposedly unbreakable hill of P2, Minnesota had a momentary lapse. Linz leaves Scrap one shot, but no one gets the trade, and Scrap ends up pulling off a three-piece, breaking the hill with 30 seconds left. Linz comes out off spawn, sprinting through the tunnel, and manages to kill Insight, who was holding the cross. He then turns around and gets a double kill on Envoy and Kleenex, showcasing some on-the-fly game sense. But unfortunately, his teammates couldn't sync up, and Toronto capitalized, extending their lead to 65 points heading into P3. Minnesota then gets broken within the first 10 seconds of P3, and Ultra comfortably closes it out with Scrap popping off.
Going into this game, but not only do they have to continue to put the pressure on here, they've got to be wary of the rotation, and they've got to be more wary of Scrap as he goes to work. That two-piece may have ended it.
Yeah, that's going to call game right there, Minnesota. They got to get the old time, and they cannot rotate over towards new. That is now 14.
Now on to game two, Search and Destroy on Karachi. Linz leading the CDL in SND First Bloods with 34 and total kills with 148, lands a Kobe on Kleenex right off the bat, setting the tone. He follows it up with a kill on Insight at the A site, helping Rocker close out the round with the bomb planted at B.
Nothing, backing down in the right moment as well. Rocker have to execute with the man advantage. They do exactly that, and they kill Scrap in the end.
No, Game 2 sees intense back and forth action, heading into a crucial round 9 tied at 4. Accuracy gets taken down mid-map by Scrap, and Kleenex gets aggressive, managing to get one before falling, giving Ultra the 2v3 advantage. Linz rushes Scrap, evening the odds to a 2 versus 2.
Scrap send that player go towards the back. This is a huge gunfight, and Linz will win it! That is huge!
Ultra play it safe, setting up on the B site, while Minnesota plants the bomb on A. With just 25 seconds left, it's a test of who's cooler under pressure. Insight, the SND demon, makes the play on Linz, and Envoy clutches up with just 1 second to spare.
Check this bomb a few times, Insight will find the first, but it's all down now to Vivid. Can they find him? Can they get him? He's gonna be seen there, gets the first, but not quick enough! And that'll be the defused. Ultra get it in just a second.
God, that is insane, dude. That is the difference maker between two teams like this, where Rocker do so many things right.
Linz then has a takeover moment with an insane route and trigger discipline to secure the triple and push game two to a round 11.
They want to end this here. They're going through with the bodies. The doors slam open. Found a waking up top though.
Oh, hello. Hello.
All the way to the back, that's two already. Flying out, the third will fall down from Awakening, and Kleenex is left alone, and Linz will get his third. Unbelievable. There was a gap, and it was exploited to the fullest.
Dude, that was exploited instantaneously. Good trigger discipline as well. The route on point. I'm not kidding. Even the round before, Linz is straight up making plays. He has been single-handedly winning so many rounds, but there you see the timing just straight in through the window. and slams him next to the wall right there for two. And of course, the follow-up after the fact, Linz might just be a top five play of the week.
Round 11 spells disaster for Minnesota as Toronto clutch up, taking a 2-0 series lead.
He's going to go down. 2 versus 2. 19 seconds left on the clock. Kleenex going to have to check this bomb for a second. Finds him, guns him. Vivid's going to go down at 1 versus 1. He will not check this bomb till 7.5. Awakening has to commit. That's all he can do as Kleenex will fly out the window, sees him, guns him, and it's done. The streak continues. 9 for Toronto Ultra.
Next up was Karachi Control, and right off the bat, Linz makes a great defensive play by hitting the flank with Awakening to secure the double, then rushes towards the A point to gun scrap out of his socks.
Linz is the pressure. He's able to pick up two and even work in the flank. Linz is frying in this moment. Hell of a way to start this Karachi.
With Minnesota now leading 1-0 after a solid defensive hold, they attempt to work on B following a comfortable A capture. Linz, straight off the spawn, takes a route and flanks through Toronto. Toronto's spawn, gaining godlike timing on scrap and opening up the point.
And now Ultra, a tight setup of their own. It's going to be scrap watching the flank. Everybody else pushed up into red, but accuracy does strike first.
Scrap just got to wait this. This is all patience for him. And with that spawn come through, the COD timing for Linz is godlike. Unbelievable. The split second, he breaks through. He stops the clock. He causes the issues for Ultra. And now Rocker have an opportunity.
However, Minnesota fails to capitalize, and Toronto holds strong on the defense.
The second, and it's close for Rocker, but not enough. Two ticks is the silver lining.
Yeah, a little too fast for their britches, I think, in that round. There's not a lot of opportunities you can get.
Moving on to the second offensive round for Minnesota, with just a minute on the clock, Ultra applies pressure, and Rocker finds themselves stuck in their spawns. Who's the one to alleviate the pressure? Yep, it's Linz once again, securing a three-piece and hopping on the A-point to extend the time and provide Minnesota with space to push further.
Envoy, though, has almost been handling these players right now, doing so much damage, slowing the pace down so much. But great news for Rocker, they're getting kills on the flip side, so Envoy is only a nuisance. He has been dealt with. The third tick on A, nearly gone.
Linz then secures a clean double, allowing Minnesota the opportunity to finally close out Game 3 and extend the series.
Still keeping the pressure up, still making Ultra dance to their beat of the drum. There are players everywhere. Accuracy says thank you very much, old Watch War. They've got bodies all over it, looking for these next kills. That might be it for Rocker. They've got three. They've cleaned house. It is done.
The Minnesota Rocker out here playing with their chest. Not, you don't even need to call the crews. Just bullying them out towards the end and applying the pressure.
Rio Hardpoint for Game 4, and it was a bang out. With Vivid the Engagement Warlord and Linz the Cracked Rookie, Minnesota pushed Toronto to their limits in a back and forth game. In the final moments, the Rookie made a heads up play. Check this out. With 15 seconds on the old hill, Ultra are already setting up for the next rotation. Linz finds the gap in their setup and hits the perfect flank to apply pressure on both sides.
Over towards the catwalk. This is one of the few hills where Ultra had the most success, and now they're...
It wasn't quite enough to break Toronto's setup as Scrap goes beast mode, and Ultra brings the game back to just a 30-point difference.
Close that door, but it's a two-front war. You got pressure on both sides, so Ultra, only three guns up, two directions to look. They might not be able to get it done because it looks like the pressure from Rocker enough to at least overwhelm to get them off the time until they slam you, get the four down, and take it right back.
Minnesota shatters Toronto's insane 14 hardpoint win streak record and takes the series to Game 5, giving them a shot at completing the reverse sweep.
Scorches through, picks up two, 10 seconds away, Rocker win this game.
Here we go, this might be it, this might be completely over. Now the bodies are falling, Ultra are falling, Scrap finds one, but it's not going to be enough. The bodies are going, and the streak is eliminated. It will be Rocker taking this to a map 5. They took down the Titans of Hardpoint, and now they have to get one more map for that sweet win, but they have done...
Invasion Search and Destroy was an absolute disaster for Minnesota. I mean, talk about the biggest throw we've seen all year happening right in round 1.
They go for it. Staying in this game when all hope was lost.
Oh,
the flank for Scrap, and they find a miracle on this map in the first round.
That is a scam and a half, Minnesota Rocker. Not the ice you are looking for. That is unfortunate. Awakening, he just drops the ball. He panics a little bit, shoots just a little bit too soon without standing up.
After that, it's like everything just started crumbling like dominoes for the Rocker. They ended up getting swept and took their first loss of the CDL Major 2 qualifiers. Linz and Accuracy were the only two players from Minnesota who managed to finish the series with a positive KD. But hey, let's be real here. Facing off against the CDL Major 1 champions, it's no surprise they took the L. Still, they gave it their absolute all out there, proving to everyone that they're definitely a top 4 team in the game, no doubt about it. Linz and the Minnesota squad squared up against Optic Texas next, kicking things off with Rio Hardpoint. Right here, Linz makes some clutch moves, bagging two crucial kills to help Minnesota push forward and get a shot at breaking the next hill. Then he sneaks around for a cheeky flank, taking down two more Optic players, making it easy for his team to bust that hill wide open. That move alone makes Optic cough up at least 30 points after they set up shop first, and it leaves them scrambling for the next rotation, having to charge through the old hill to avoid falling behind by 100. As the action moves back to P1, Linz takes charge of the bridge door, wiping out the entire enemy team, including Kenny, who was eyeing up a sneaky move from the old hill. That secures his team the initial time and sets him up perfectly. Fast forward to Minnesota being just 2 points away from slamming the door on game one, and guess who comes up big again? Yep, Linz. He breaks another hill for Minnesota, taking out Pred and Shotzi and bagging another double to clinch a 1-0 lead in the series.
It looks improbable. Rocker have been so good across the entire map, and they're going to try and go for a break here from the top side. If they can find a kill over the top, Linz is going to be there to support, watching the flank that's inevitably coming through. The stun is there, a bit of timing though, and all of a sudden Linz could be the straw that breaks the camel's back. Linz, Vivid, find a way through, and Optic Texas fall like dominoes towards the end of that.
He wraps the game with a jaw-dropping 1.86 KD, while also topping the damage charts with over 5k damage dealt. Dominant performance by the rookie. Diving into game 2, Search and Destroy on Terminal, the first Blood King, Linz, goes all out with an aggressive push toward the B-bomb site, setting his team up nicely for a potential plant. In the next round, Minnesota finds themselves in a tight 2-versus-3 on defense. But fear not, Linz steps up big time on the A site, timing his moves perfectly to take out Pred and slip away before Dashy or Shotzi could even think about trading him.
But I mean, Optic haven't bit on anything. Still worried about the playing pressure. Linz, though, strikes to even things out to a 2v2, and all this time wasted might end up punishing Optic.
25 seconds. Oh, Shotzi's on his way over.
Then Linz finds himself in a 1v1 showdown against Shotzi. You already know how that went down.
Kill if you can find it. Accuracy with the gunny onto Dashy. Linz knows exactly where Shotzi is. Bomb picked up. 13 seconds. Is he going to watch the cross, or is he just going to give it up a little bit? It looks like he's going to give it a shot into the back, though. Shotzi will just about get away, and we'll have time to plan. Utility is there for Linz, but not enough to do anything about this bomb going down. Shotzi backing up. 1v1, 40 seconds to go.
Yeah, and Linz doesn't have any intel on where Shotzi was able to go, other than he hasn't crossed out towards Xe. So Linz right now trying to clear as much of the map as possible. But on an intel front, you have to know Shotzi, massive advantage right now in this round.
Linz in a really, really sticky spot. Shotzi's just going to hold this down, going to go for the wide challenge. Just about maybe a little bit of fortune for Linz if he can get it, but Shotzi is offering his nothing up so far, just being the slippery little snake.
Oh!
But Linz guns him. Is he going to get there in time? Absolutely. My word. Absolutely shotguns him from there. Incredible from Linz. And they tie it up. Big round to kick things off there for Minnesota Rocker. One apiece.
Oh, the new rookie against the previous rookie of the year in Shotzi's introduction gets the best of him in the 1v1, and it really just is a shred job in this moment. Shotzi overcommits on the chow, but the reason he does is because the gunfight in
that was a massive bounce back round for Minnesota to dodge, falling behind 2-0 in the SND. On another offensive push for Minnesota, they decide to hit up the B-bomb site, and guess who steals the show again? Yep, Linz, snagging a sweet double, cracking open the site, and sealing the deal on the offensive round win for the Rocker.
Great, but Minnesota Rocker, complete control of the site. Linz will find one. Linz will find the second. The chow coming through.
Fast forward to round 10. It's the climax of the SND. Minnesota pulls off a daring flank play, and who else but Linz steps up with a huge double to bring game 2 to a close.
least gets one, but now the pressure on the site. Two players from Optic just surrounded, and through the smoke comes Minnesota Rocker soaring, and Pred can't get it done. Lin's sealing their fate. His gun.
Rocker is now just one map away from sealing the series. Just gotta shout out Lin's real quick. He's heading into the third map with a solid 2KD against Optic in this series. And let me tell you, he came out swinging in Karachi Control too. But man, oh man, that map turned out to be a wild ride. We seriously need to start calling this move the Lin's Flank. I mean, seriously, he's like a ninja out there. He catches wind that they're capping the A point, and with Awakening covering fire, he times it just right to swoop in from the side and bam. Not one, not two, but a triple kill to defend the A site. We even catch Kenny's reaction through the listen in.
He's on air now. We either take.
On air, Lin's.
Just when it seemed like Optic might break out of their spawn, guess who's playing the sneaky game again? You got it, it's Lin's. He manages to snag a quick double before biting the dust.
Good job, Lin's is just playing the exact same role. And here comes the cleanup crew, one, two for Lin's, the third will be wonderful, can't quite find it, Shotzi does so well.
For the unfortunately of the game, for Minnesota, they couldn't hold them back any longer. Now we got ourselves a tied up control game. Minnesota goes huge to win another offensive round with clutch plays on the B point, and let's just check out where Lin's is on the map. I'm telling you, this guy will flank everything. He's so annoying to deal with.
Water through the map there. Optic Texas don't know which way to look, and there's another attacking.
But anyway, Optic takes game 3 all the way to round 5 and pulls off the impossible in a 3 versus 14 situation to snatch the offensive win. And just like that, we got ourselves one heck of a series on our hands.
Still potential here from Optic.
I think I might hear a cruise missile in the sky. I think Awakening might have gone on this spree right now, but no control and no dice. Three players on the point. The after extra kill, it's a 3v3.
Gotta go. You gotta go if you're Rocket. You're locking it down. If you're Optic Texas, make it one kill from Shotzi. Lin's, can he find the cleanup here? It's Dashy to find one more. Can they lock it in time? It's a 3 versus 12 in the end from Optic. Round number 5 goes their way. Head in your hands moment for Rocker. Series.
Sub-base hardpoint, another shot for Minnesota to seal the deal in this series. And wouldn't you know it, Lin's comes out swinging again, kicking off with a fiery 4 spree right out of the gate.
In the swing of things, Lin's right back where he left off this entire series. He's been on point, strikes for the first
just
two.
Controlling, but yeah, for Optic, it's got to be feeling good, right? But the same has to be said from them. A nice start here as well. It just probably feels like the game will run away for you. A little bit of control here from Rocker, though. At the same time, Optic Texas will be more than happy to keep hold of the spawns
right
now.
These were neck and neck mid-game, both teams sitting pretty at 130 points apiece. But then, the Rookie of the Year decides to crank it up a notch, and bam, Rocker starts cruising after that sick move.
Needed to do much with. All of a sudden, Optic Texas, well, they did have a bit of presence over towards P1. Looking like that's going to get wiped off the map. Oh, Prince, it's a tough one. I don't even want to call it a turn-on, really. Lin's was there to pick up the pieces, shooting at two different bodies. It's a tough gunfight to take.
Optic's dug in at the new hill, but hold up, check out Lin's working that flank, playing it smooth to stay alive and help Rocker bust up that hill without breaking a sweat.
Reads the gunfight toward the back, which he does exactly that, but you gotta get the kill. Lin's dances on him, gets the break in Minnesota Rocker, maybe making the best of an awkward situation. It's still a bit of a square up, but right now Optic just struggling to win the gunfights around the hill.
Yeah, and it's just not something you would expect to say from players.
Lin's was a one-man army throughout this whole series. I mean, Awakening's dropping 7 kills in 7 minutes of play. 7? Come on, Big Wake, we need you to step it up. Well, Optic ain't giving up easily. They claw their way back into it and drag the series all the way to a game 5 after pulling off one heck of a hardpoint comeback.
What's the play for here? Over towards the last hill. We're going to another rotation chance. It's anybody's game.
Yeah, but look at the spawns from Shotzi too. Shotzi ends up spawning behind a few players, so you're able to make sure they spawn sort of in the deep trenches out towards the warehouse side of the map, but now the spawns are just out of control. Inaccuracy picks up too as soon as the hill pops. Rocker desperate just to flood this time.
Jump in the point. 5 seconds to go for Minnesota Rocker. Optic Texas is going to be pretty much perfect to find a couple of kills. Dashy will find a second to himself. Vivid can't find a thing.
Shot.
3 from Dashy. 10 seconds away now for Optic Texas. Complete control for Rocker. It's a hard break back from here. 7 seconds to go. The shots in from Awakening are good, but you need to start moving if you're Rocker. The kill feed's just starting to light up green. And Vivid can get in for the contest, but I don't think it's going to be enough. He's still surviving. The rest of the team on their way. Vivid has went massive for the team, but it's not enough.
up to Texas, force them up number 5 in an absolute banger of a sub-base hardpoint. It's a 5-point game, and map number 5 on the way.
It's game 5 time, folks, where everything's on the line, and let me tell you, Linz was on fire once again. Let's break down that first round. We see Linz making moves, pushing the cash area up to top green and nabbing a perfect spot to take out Pred Chillin on top AC.
Rocker are just going to hold tight and wait to see what Linz can do here.
Man, I'm kind of surprised Pred never turned to look for him. And yeah,
another first blood for Linz. Then he plays it smart, ducking into a sneaky corner bottom green and keeping his hide intact. Linz then catches Kenny slipping mid-push with some perfect timing for a flank. Now it's a 2v3 with the bomb planted and just 30 seconds left on the clock. Should be game over for Optic if Rocker plays their cards right. But oh man, Shotzi pulls off some magic and swings the lead back in Optic's favor.
Gets away, but Shotzi, he's gone for the defuse, awakening eyes on. Shots in, not quite good enough. Shotzi then turns it, he got out the
right
time. My god, Shotzi! Big plays, a big moment. Optic Texas wanted the good.
That can't happen! That can't happen! Shotzi is too good!
Fast forward to round 5, scores sitting at 3-1, and Minnesota's dug in at the A site. Linz strikes first blood again on Kenny, then plays it cool in a sneaky corner in Optic spawn, eventually taking out Dashy too, and Rocker seals the deal with an offensive round win.
Got the break, but Pred on the flag taking his time, but needs to start making a move because accuracy will find Shotzi as well. He's a very noisy boy. And Linz will find another kill on the Dashy. Pred now in a 1v3. That just seems very improbable. Next kill's obviously massive for the side of Rocker. They'll win around it, but if Pred can make this a 1v2, not gonna happen. Accuracy with the read. Really good round coming in from Rocker.
Calling now on to the next round. Same old Linz, same old story. Another first blood, followed by a takedown on Pred, who gives away his position. Kenny trades, making it a 2v2 situation.
Love it towards right there for the trade again. It's 4 in a row from Linz. Can't get away from the jaws of Kenny.
Vivid gets team nated by accuracy, and the round's pretty much a wrap.
She swung all the way around. You know these players are going to be doubled up around ticket.
First kill will be huge. Accuracy information is there for Optic Texas. Oh, and he's killed his teammate with the grenade.
This is a make or break moment for Minnesota. Lose it, and they're down 5-2, staring defeat in the face. Win it? Well, you're still in the game, just a round behind. And I'll just let the clip speak for itself.
Next kill's huge. Linz just playing his life, as is Vivid, but Shotzi will find him. They know exactly where Linz is. It's a 1v2. Shots in. Tadashi are solid. Can he find the second?
Linz!
As well. And you, French Venom, Ms. Linz will find a second.
Linz does it again with a nasty 1v2, reading the situation perfectly. It's yet another 2v3 man advantage for Rocker, but somehow they fumble it again. Nothing's clicking for this squad, and Optic's just one round away from pulling off the reverse sweep.
Any bad news from Optic? Maybe they don't have the bomb. Good news is you made it behind them. He's pinched in between two players and they're gonna get the kill. Optic, they do
it. Awakening gets blooded and Linz reads Pred like a book, firing back.
The potential was there. Pred will put the bullets in and just continues to survive. Optic Texas starting to tighten their grip now. Huge moment. Linz will find it.
A 2v3 situation, bombs down with 20 seconds left. Vivid rushes towards the bomb, probably feeling the pressure, thinking they're going for the ninja defuse, and Linz is left in another 1v2 situation.
And if anybody's going to clutch this up for the side of Minnesota Rocker, it's going to be the young Frenchman that shots into the bomb carrier is going to land. Can he find the second gunfight as well? Shots, he finds it. Will he get there in time? It's looking like
perfectly played by Linz, but Shotzi spots him from the window and takes him down, defusing the bomb with a mere 0.4 seconds left on the clock. Tough loss for Minnesota, and get this, Linz ends the map with more kills than his whole team combined. Now that's just plain crazy. The next challenge for Minnesota came in the form of Boston Breach. Game 1 was like a smackdown from Boston's side, especially with Snoopy going all out, racking up 32 kills and 21 deaths. Poor Linz had a rough time, being the main SMG on a map like Invasion Hardpoint, which favors the AR players. In the SND, Boston started strong again, taking a 2-0 lead, but then Linz stepped up big time, scoring a quick double in round 3 and snagging the first kill in round 4, bringing the score even.
Players leaning down B Street. Linz in position, first blood, it is done perfectly already.
Next round, Linz strikes again with a sneaky first blood on Snoopy at B site, putting Minnesota ahead 3-2.
Oh, he hasn't checked it. He hasn't fully checked it. Snoopy is still here. Hello. Lin spots him. There you go. Eventually he does get a hold.
Lin's keeps the heat up, going on a 5-streak, taking down a seam, and sealing the deal with the final kill.
The player to watch on the 5-spree. One more kill of Cruz can be devastating on this map. And he's got it.
There it is. The seam falls, and all of a sudden, he can just stay alive. The reinforcements should be on their way, but he does want better. Priest inside of Dark, taking down as well. Make it 7 in a row from Linz to finish off.
With the cruise missile called in, Minnesota secures positioning and closes out the round comfortably.
Players outside by Palace. That's going to be at least one freebie. There goes Priesta. Accuracy does get blooded in the meantime, but at least you get the bomb planted.
Now Slasher should have a dead to rights, but Vivid will find one. Slasher managed to clean it up, but Linz is there for another.
In the final moments, Minnesota's strategy pays off big time, thanks to Linz and Awakening taking control of the A building, which ties up the series.
Feel this out. Double chow in the middle. Good luck with this one, trying to read it. Both kills fall into Big Wake's lap. The play call is
come
perfect.
Roaring back into this game. Accuracy finds Priester. One apiece. Rocket bounce back in the search and destroying the walls continue.
Linz finishes the SND with a light 3KD ratio, sealing the deal for Minnesota. Alright, buckle up for Game 3 control, back on Invasion. Minnesota and Boston are deadlocked at one apiece after some solid defensive plays from both squads. Boston's holding firm on defense, looking to keep the pressure on, but then Linz pulls off a sick move, turning the tables on Snoopy and shutting down any chance of capturing Tix.
But it doesn't matter, my word! Snoopy gets dealt with. My word! Snoopy gets dealt with.
The rookie goes on an absolute tear, racking up a 7-kill spree, earning that cruise missile for Minnesota. They defend flawlessly, not giving up a single tick and securing the defensive side for round 5.
Reach. Phenomenal from Rocker to send us to round number 5, and defense will well and truly be theirs.
Minnesota's sweating a bit with a seam causing chaos in their spawn, but Lin sniffs him out and takes him down.
Help, but you could win it one of two ways, but you take too long.
Just a few moments later, when it seems like Snoopy's being sneaky in their spawn, Lin shuts him down once again. With that, Rocker seals the deal in game 3, taking the series lead 2-1.
It's back, 6 seconds to go. If you're Boston, you just gotta hightail it. The team will find one. He's not gonna be close enough. Minnesota Rocker, hold it down. Round number 5 win. Find themselves a lead in the series.
And Minnesota's chance to close out the series comes on Subbase Hardpoint, the same map where they had a major slip-up against Optic. Linz comes in clutch with a 3-piece, breaking into P2 with just 25 seconds left on the clock.
Collecting the time.
Good stuff from Accuracy. Linz coming in to finish Slasher off. Really good break coming in through the Minnesota Rocket, who we want to
after a continuous back and forth affair, we're fast forwarding to the final moments of the game. Game 4 goes down to the wire, and Linz steps up with some crucial kills to help Minnesota hold the point for a precious few seconds.
Time, you certainly play for the kills, but you can be aggressive and take away a few seconds here, a few seconds there. Minnesota Rocker, though, winning the gunfights. Oh, no. That's a nice little clearance as well, so keeping things up. Make no mistake, Rocker can also win on this hill. They don't have the top third control, but we're about to have a near tied up game. You gotta win these gunfights, though. Lane's the pop-off moment, able to give you the big two. Keep it busting.
However, Boston Breach closes it out in the end to force a game 5.
It's away from either two teams, and now here comes Linz. Can find one, nothing towards the backside. Boston in full control. If you're Vivid, you found the spawns that give you something in this game. You now need to find multiple kills, or we're heading to map number 5, and that's where we're going. Boston Breach, deservedly, if anything.
Here we go again. It's the third map 5 for Minnesota in the major 2 qualifiers. They've gotta clinch this one, right? Dropping this game 5 against Boston, who holds the worst SND record, would be a total nightmare. Boston Breach is absolutely owning the SND. Minnesota's just struggling to keep up, round after round, slipping away from them. They finally get a foothold in round 5, but it's too little, too late. Boston shuts them down in the final stretch, taking the last 2 rounds and securing that game 5 victory. Tough break for Minnesota.
Pin back where he really doesn't want to be when he slipped the net. Oh my word, but it doesn't work out for him. Boston, beware search and destroy.
So Minnesota's now sitting at 0-3 in the major 2 qualifiers, thanks to these gut-wrenching Game 5 losses. Their shot at redemption comes tomorrow against Atlanta FaZe, followed by a showdown with the LA Thieves on Sunday. Linz has been pulling a solid 1.08 KD throughout these losses. Excited to see what he's got in store for us this weekend. That wraps it up for today's episode. What do you reckon? Should Linz be in the running for MVP of the season? Because honestly, he's already the rookie of the year in my book. Thanks for sticking around till the end. You're the reason I'm dishing out these breakdown vids, and I ain't stopping anytime soon. This is the COD Archive. Catch you on the flip side. Take care.